Let's see what it is that this man's erasing. Chelsea Manning is a hero. Chelsea Manning is one of the few veterans I have any respect for, because Chelsea Manning stands up for the truth. All this unchecked aggression against the dolphins. What did a dolphin ever do to you? There goes a smiley face. The fact that you have no sort of response to me indicates your lack of intellectual depth. I thought it was funny on the Stop Free Keene page, one of the responses that people had to my article was, he uses a lot of big words. I mean, it sounds like the lesser educated, the more barbarian, lesser civilized individuals are interested in censoring free speech. What do your parents think of this? I can't imagine you call mom or dad and say, hey mom, dad, there were these kids downtown chalking today. I washed up their chalk. I protected this one. You have nothing to express because it's like you're trying to fill a black hole in your heart. There's nothing to fill it with. Do you feel better with each chalking that you remove? Do you feel like you've expressed something or taught something to the world? If you feel people aren't educated, why aren't you trying to educate them in some way, rather than just trying to destroy what other people have made? But it's not about making something better for you. It's about something you don't like and trying to get rid of it. Just think about building something or growing something rather than destroying things. You don't even have a message for the world. All you have is removal of messages that exist. I mean, it speaks volumes, but is that what you want your life to mean? Wipe that smile off that sidewalk. I mean, it's like, I don't know, I can't even measure the depth of the silliness of this. At some point, you'll stop caring about this and start caring about things that matter. I know where he's going. I have to save the one smile. Yeah. I don't have any more chalk on me, so preserving that one little bit of bright light and bright color in Keene today shall be my prerogative until 5. Oh, I forgot there were any more over there. It's 4:40, Friday, October 24th. I gotta hand it to you. That was some quick thinking. You're faster than I thought. I hope it. I mean, it's like you beat. All right, you beat me there. I gotta hand it to you. Had I known we were having a race, if you said like 1, 2, 3, go, I think I would have had it. You got me this time, but. I think next time, to be fair, call it out, and we'll do it legit, like, we'll be ready, 1, 2, 3, go. And I'm telling you, if we do it legit, I'm totally on it. I would totally be the winner. But that was fun, dude. That was fun. Maybe tomorrow we can try it again. I don't have any more chalk today. Do you think if I got you a GoPro to wear for when you do this, you could wear it? Because I think it'd be cool to get both perspectives. please do be careful when you pull out. The way you pulled out on Winter Street was kind of fast. You almost caused an accident.
No, you caused the accident because you had the camera on.
The camera should not distract you. If you're driving and the camera distracts you, you probably shouldn't drive. What I would have said was that it's important that when you're driving, you don't let things distract you. If things might distract you, you probably shouldn't be driving. Now that was safe. There was no traffic coming when he pulled out. On Winter Street, that wasn't so much the case. But I do care about safety, even the safety of people who may not care about my safety. I mean, I'm not saying Boston doesn't care about my safety, but he does seem to be a very angry person. Doesn't seem to be a very neighborly person. So just, you know, looking out for everybody.